Namaskar, this is Mrs. Neela Kalyan Jagdare, and today we'll be discussing what are folds. The other day we studied what is plant, what is rake. Yes. Today we are going to continue with the topic that is folds. Yeah. And if you're to be defining what folds are, yes, being geologist or any human being, normal person, know what a fold is. Fold is nothing but it's just a bend. Yes. So if we are talking about, you know, folds in rocks. Yes, we are talking about folding. Yeah, we are talking about folds in rocks. So what is it? It is nothing but it is like this. Okay, it is either up wrap or down wrap, or you may say curvatures. Yes, bends, curvatures, or undulation, or you know, wave like pattern like this. Bends, curvatures, undulations, or wave like pattern. Yes, all these are, you know, can be termed as folds. Okay, or all these terms make up what a fold is. Yes. Okay, so if you're to be defining folds basically, or before defining folds, first thing that we should first understand is, being geologists, we know three types of rocks: igneous, metamorphic, sedimentary. Now folding will happen in all the rocks. It's not necessary that happens only in sedimentary rocks, okay? But mostly we stick to sedimentary rocks because we find, you know, hydrocarbons, or you know, most of the things, placer deposits in sedimentary, okay? Fine. But however, and sedimentary is more, you know, easier to understand basically if you're talking folds, because we study, you know, order of superposition of beds. Order of superposition meaning the position of beds, or the position of beds with respect to the earlier bed, okay, or the age of it, which tells us the age of the bed, okay. And you know, now that I use the term age, I don't know, it just striked me. I always say this actually, and I don't know if you guys believe this or not, but I'm a person who says that, you know, and this is my own philosophy, okay. What I feel is, people say that rocks don't talk, yeah, but that is, you know, rocks, yeah, after all, what is there in a rock? But frankly speaking, rocks tell us the oldest story ever that no human being can tell us. Only thing is, we need to decipher what it is. Yeah, decipher. You have to study, you have to understand, and you have to decipher what are the rocks trying to tell us. What is the story? What is the, you know, story that they want to tell us? Yes, so they can. It's just like how we say animals can't talk. Actually, they do. Yeah, they talk in their own languages and they speak to one another. But we are like, we don't understand it. Now, that's why we come up saying they don't talk. Yeah. Because we are human beings, right? We are superior. We consider ourselves to be superior. Anyways, fine. Coming back again. The reason why I told this philosophy of mine is because, you know, I use the term age. And when I talked about age, I thought about that philosophy of mine which says that, that rocks actually really tell us a lot. Okay, something that no human being can tell us what has happened on this planet, but rocks can tell us. Only thing, we need to decipher it. Okay, this is why geology is interesting. Yes, okay, fine. Coming back again, so we were talking about order of superposition of rocks. Okay, when we understand what is the, you know, position of one bed with respect to another. Okay, and we are talking about beds in terms of what? In terms of sedimentary rock. This is with respect to sedimentary rocks. The other day we were talking about how sediments, you know, get deposited in the sedimentary basin, okay, be it oceans, yes, or seas, and there you get deposition of layers, one over the other, yes, and they give rise to formation of sedimentary rocks. Now what is happening is, see, understand one thing. If you have one layer of rock, yes, the other layer over it, yes. Yep, and say one more layer over it, yes, and not necessarily the thickness of all the rocks is same, yes, not necessary that the thickness of all the rocks is same, they vary, the thickness keeps on varying, yeah. So thickness, we are talking about the vertical thickness, okay. This is so fine, this is so small, it is very thin bed, this is okay, and this is a little thicker, right? So the thickness of sedimentary rocks may vary depending upon the rate of deposition, depending upon the source area from where the sediments are coming. Lot many factors play a role here. Alright, so when we are talking about different sedimentary rocks, what we see is a rock which is deposited right at the bottom, okay, understand this one thing, because with respect, in order to understand folds, it's not that we need to understand this only to understand folds, but if you understand this, understanding folds become much easier. Okay, so if we have this oldest rock that is deposited, yes, the very first layer of rock, then one, you know, then a source comes in and you get another layer that is deposited, yes. So that is one more layer that is deposited of rocks. Then one more thing comes in, one more layer gets deposited. So you have deposition of rocks one over the other, okay. In this case, what is happening is, this one, the one which is at the bottom, right at the bottom, is the oldest layer of rock. Age-wise, yes. Why? Because it is being deposited very first, right? Then you have deposition one over the other, one over the other, one over the other. And the topmost will be youngest in age. Is this clear, right? So we have oldest at the bottom and youngest at the top. Normally, has to be like that. Yes? Now, what is happening is, when we are talking about folds, the other day we discussed what is anticlinal fold, what is synclinal fold. Again, we'll have a small revision. Or rather, you know, going ahead, you know, you've understood what is younger beds and what is older beds, right? Now, what we'll understand is, in folding, we'll first study the definition, then we'll move on further. It's very easy, right? Now, what is happening is, what is fold? Fold is nothing but it is the bends, the curvatures, okay, or you may say, you know, the wrapping that is happening, yes, in the rocks. Yes, so the bends, the curvatures, the wrapping, W-R-A-P-P-I-N-G, I'm talking about the wrapping, or the undulations, the wavy pattern, yes, the wavy pattern is what is nothing but folds, okay. You may stick to four basic things. You remember bends, curvatures, undulations and wavy patterns. Yes, this is what is fold. In rocks, yeah, caused due to stresses. You remember the definition of structural geology? Structural geology is a branch of geology which deals with what? It deals with the architecture of the rock insofar as it is resulted with the deformation which is caused due to stresses. You remember the stresses thing? So here also same thing. Why is this wrapping, why are the undulations and wavy pattern and curves happening in the rock? Why? This is basically because of the stresses. Which stresses acting here mostly? You remember studying four stresses? Yes, here mostly the stresses acting. The compressional stresses, the lateral stresses which bring compression. They compress the rock, yes. But is it only the compressional force necessarily? No, there are several other forces also which may act, which may give rise to formation of folding. Yes? Okay. Now, because see, one simple example I'll give you. See. One simple example, okay? It's just not compressional forces. I'll tell you why. Because, see, if there is compression here at the bottom, yes, what will happen at the top of the fold or top of the fold? The highest point of the fold is known as crest. Yes, we'll be studying different parts of fold, but I just sort of telling you, just not because I'm using the term top. Instead of using the term top, correct term is crest. Yes, I want to use the term that, and I want you to understand that before, prior to using the term. Alright, so what is the thing here? What is the crest? Crest is the highest point or highest, position of a fold. Highest point of a fold is nothing but crest. So what is the crest here? The crest is this part here. Alright, this is the crest of the fold. Now what is happening is, we were talking about forces, compressional forces, and at the crest what is happening then? This at the crest, which forces do you think are acting? See, okay, compressional forces gave rise to fold. But at the top here, what will happen is, you'll be having tensional forces that are acting here. The tension at the top, okay, the strata here is going to subjected to tensional forces. They are going to go away, are you understanding? The lateral, laterally stratas practically will go away, kind of, okay, which will lead to fracturing of rocks at the crest of the anticline. This is what kind of fold? This is an anticlinal fold. Yes, we used a term the other day, anticline and syncline. In anticline, I told you, nomenclature, if you're talking about how are the folds named, kind of, okay, nomenclature. This is known as anticline fold. Why? Because the limbs are dipping away, away, cline, inclination, cline, inclination, angle, dipping, yes. So what is happening here is that limbs are dipping away from one another. These are the two limbs. Yes, we will be studying different parts of fold. However, the other day I had explained to you what a limb is. The limbs, these are the two limbs of fold. Okay. These are the limbs of fold. Okay, so now what is happening when the limbs are dipping away from one another? Anti, against. Although that is anticline. When the limb is syncline, again. When the limbs are dipping towards one another, this is a syncline. Yes? So you know what is anticlinal fold? You know what is synclinal fold. Yeah? So now what we are talking, what is the definition of fold? If it will be defining fold. Fold can be defined as undulation, wavy pattern, bending or curvatures which are caused in the rocks. Yes, within the rocks, mainly due to the stresses in the rocks. Yes, after writing the definition, you ought to be drawing a small figure quickly, you know, with the help of pencil. Just draw a quick figure besides the definition also. It is always better to draw figures because whoever is evaluating your papers, yes, will understand that you have understood the subject. So, wherever possible, draw figures. I don't know how many of you have noted, but mostly on all the question papers, it is written, figures to the right indicate full marks. However, don't think about full marks all the time, because it should be correct figure and, you know, everything should be perfect. Only then that full marks thing is valid. However, you should be, you know, correct on your side. You should be perfect on your side, and that is why you should be drawing quick figures. No matter which subject, guys, remember this. Whichever subject, you can always make your own figures and you can draw them. Yes, fine. So coming here towards folds again. So define fold. Fold is nothing but it is the wavy pattern, the undulations, the bends or the curvatures in the rocks. Yes, which are caused due to stresses in the rocks. Quickly, that is a fold, and you should quickly draw a fold there. Okay, and you can label it also. This is a fold, this is anticline, this inclined fold. Quickly, a small figure. No need to, you know, draw all the parts and all, because you're just defining it. All right, definition is hardly going to be 2 marks or something like that, and you can't, you know, give a lot of time there. All right, so then invest a lot of time in just giving different parts of folds in that small figure. All right, so then that is the definition of fold. If someone asks what is the definition of folding, very easy. The process, yes, the process in which the rocks undergo bending, okay, or they show undulations or wavy pattern, or, you know, they are curved, they become curved due to stresses in the rock, is what is folding. And again, a quick figure there. Okay, so you know definition of fold and you know definition of folding also. Now, if you're talking about different parts of fold now, all right, the other day we discussed, however, I will be dealing with this a little in detail just now. Parts of fold, we know for now, just understand the two folds. You all know that is anticline and syncline. Yes, so you have anticlinal fold, you have synclinal fold. Yes, now I told you crest is the highest point of the fold. However, hinge, H-I-N-G, hinge is the line where the two limbs come together. Okay, be it together or be it away. So this is even a trough. That is the lowest part of the fold is known as a trough. Highest part of the fold is known as a crest. Okay, so here in this you have crest here. This is the highest part of the fold. And this is the lowest part of the fold. This is the trough in the syncline. And this is the crest in the anticline. Yes? Alright, so what is a hinge line? Hinge line is where the two limbs come together. Okay, be it at the crest or be it at the trough. The two limbs come together here. Alright, so now understand one thing. The reason why I am stressing on crest and hinge just now is because you should understand that it is not always necessary that the crest and the hinge line is one and the same. No, I'll tell you why. And this is, you know, I mean, it's not that this thing is not very easy to understand. I will explain it and you will surely understand this once it is explained. Yes, see this. Supposing if this is the crest of the anticline, yeah, This is the crest of the anticline. For this kind of fold, the crest and the hinge line is one and the same. Why? Because the highest point is the same and the hinge is the place, or the hinge line is the line where the two limbs meet together. Alright. Now, hinge we say, brachiopods, you know, they have hinge lines, yeah. So, alright, coming. The shells, yeah. I don't know how many of you know this. But the shells that we see mostly at the seashores, those ones which open, those are brachiopods, okay. Even they have a hinge line, alright. Fine. So, coming back again. So, that is where the two things meet together, right. So, here the two limbs meeting together is what is hinge line, alright. So, here what is happening in this kind of fold, both the crest and the hinge is one and the same. However, now see this fold properly, okay. See this fold properly. The crest and the limbs are one and the same. But there can be a fold like this. There can be a fold like this. Like this. Are you getting me? Where the highest point. Wait, just a moment. Let me fold it a little bit. Yeah. See, like this. There can be a fold like this in nature. Anything can happen, right? Where the highest point of the crest is here. Okay, but the fold is a symmetrical fold. Now I'll tell you what symmetrical and asymmetrical is. Symmetrical is when the limbs of the fold, yes, these are the two limbs of the fold. What is the axis of the fold? The other day we discussed, however, I'll be telling again, axis is the topmost line of the fold. Okay, where hinge line and axis is always parallel to one another. Alright, remember this. Hinge and axis is parallel to one another. Alright. So, axis is the place where the two limbs meet again. Okay. And the other day I told you what is actual plane. Something that passes from between. Like this. Yes. It is an imaginary plane. Right. Yes. And yeah. So, when the limbs dip at equal angle. You know, everyone knows what dip is by now. Okay. So, when the limbs dip at equal angle from here and from here, from both the sides, with respect to what? With respect to the horizontal. This is the horizontal surface. With respect to the horizontal surface, when the limbs are dipping, yes, I think this will be this. This is the horizontal. When the limbs are dipping at equal angle on both the sides. What is the angle? This angle and this angle. Is this clear? See, this angle and this angle. When both these angles are equal, this is a symmetrical fold. Yes? Yeah? There. Where, however, when both these angles are unequal, they are not, you know, same. That is an asymmetrical fold. I'll tell you how. See, this is a symmetrical fold. Yes? On both the sides, it is equal. Both the angles are equal. However, it can be like this also. A fold can be like this also. You getting me? Yeah? In this case, is this a symmetrical fold? No. Why? Because the angles made on either side of the hinge line or the axis are different. Therefore, this is an asymmetrical fold. You getting me? This is an asymmetrical fold. Yeah. So, you know what is asymmetrical fold and symmetrical fold? I will just draw a quick figure for you. It will be more, you know, better, because even you guys can draw figures for that. Yeah. See. You only get follow me. Yeah. This is the horizontal surface. Yeah. With respect to this, when you have a fold like this, yeah, where both the angles on either side, theta 1, theta 2, both the angles, that is theta 1, theta 2, are equal. This is a symmetrical fold. Yes? Then you have a symmetrical fold where theta 1, theta 2. Symmetrical asymmetrical. Yeah? This is symmetrical fold, this is asymmetrical. You see this? In this, what is happening? Theta 1 is greater as compared to theta 2. You're getting, this is also a kind of fold. This is asymmetrical fold. In this case, what will happen? The actual plane here, okay, which is an imaginary plane, will bisect the fold in such a way that both the angles are equal. Okay, it will divide the fold in such a way that both the angles are equal. But here, the actual plane, okay, are you getting me? Are the angles equal? No. Therefore, it is an asymmetrical fold. Please understand the symmetrical and asymmetrical. Alright. So yeah, so the reason why we were talking about this is because we were understanding the crest and hinge part. Okay, so what is happening here? I think in this fold itself I can explain to you, but I'll first explain here again. Okay. So it is like this kind of, this is an asymmetrical fold where the highest point is this. You see, practically highest point is this. And the hinge line which is here is low. Are you getting me? Practically the highest point is here. Is here. Are you getting me? Here. But the hinge line is here. So it is not necessary that crest and hinge is always the same. Okay, crest is the highest point of the fold. Hinge is where the two limbs meet. This is this, and in this case, this is the hinge. See, this is the crest. This is the crest of the fold, and this is the crest of the fold, and this part is the hinge of the fold. This one is the hinge of the fold. I hope I am very clear. Crest is the highest point. Hinge is where the two limbs meet. This is the place. This is the place where the two limbs. This is the place where the two limbs are meeting, and this is the crest of the fold. Yes. So if you're talking about a hinge, you know what a hinge is, then you know what is crest of the fold, you know what a hinge line is, then you should also be knowing what are limbs. I told you is nothing but it is, you know, this part. But how do you define it? If you're to be defining, see, you have an anticlinal fold and you have a synclinal fold. Both anticline as well as syncline will have what? They will have axis. All the folds will have their axis. Okay, so in this case, anticlinal fold will have its own axis. See, anticlinal fold will have its own axis. Yes, and synclinal fold also will have its own axis. Anticlinal fold's axis, and this is the axis of synclinal fold. This is the axis of synclinal fold. Now, the area in between the two axes, that is this axis and this axis. Yes, area in between the two axes, that is this place, we are talking about this place, yes, this place and this place, this. Okay. Area in between the two axes, that is this axis and this axis, axis of the syncline, axis of anticline. This part is what is the limb of the fold. Practically, if you to be defining what a limb is, the part which exists in between the two axes, that is axis of anticline and axis of syncline, is what is the limb of fold. Okay, so if you are talking about parts of fold, we know what is crest, we know what is trough. Trough is the lowest. Crest, define, highest point of the fold is crest, lowest point of the fold is trough. This is the lowest point of the fold. Yes, axis of the fold is the place where, you know, the fold is divided, yes, into parts, and then hinge is the line where the limbs meet. Yes, and if you are talking about limb, it is the part in between the two distinct axes. Yes, and if you're talking about what else can we talk about, action plane is the imaginary plane that exists in between. These are the different parts of the fold. I was just trying to recall if there is anything that I would like to mention here. There is, yeah, amplitude. This is the amplitude of the fold. This, the height of the fold, is the amplitude of the fold, the height. And most of you must be knowing, as we are science students, we know what amplitude and wavelength is. And this is the wavelength of the fold. Okay, this is the wavelength of the fold. Alright. And yeah. So this was with respect to parts of fold. We know what a fold is. We know what are the different parts of fold. I'm just trying to recall if I should be mentioning is even more things, you know. Let me just recall. Is there anything else that I need to mention here? For now, I think folds and different parts feel, yeah, clear. Yeah, it is done. Different parts are also done. I'm just recalling it. I have mentioned different things. Yeah, I mean, all that should be mentioned here. So we're done with what are folds and what are the different parts of fold. I think this is what is important. Yeah, actually, you should be doing it by yourself. I told you imaginary thing, but we'll do it here again. Okay, I'll just draw a quick figure for you. This is an anticline. This is a syncline. Axial plane. limbs. Okay. Crest. Trough. Okay. So you see this figure? You see anticline, you see syncline, this is the achypate. Axis is like this. The horizontal line on the surface is what is the axis. See this, this entire thing is the axis, this is the axis of the fold, yes, and this vertical thing is the axial plane, vertically down, that is the axial plane, okay, these are the limbs of the fold, and this is the crest, and this is the trough of fold, alright, hinge line again, I told you, you can consider this to be hinge line also, yes, the top, hinge line I told you is where the folds are meeting, okay, like see for example in this fold, for example in this fold, what is happening is, the crest is here. Practically, if you see, let me use some other color pen. So, if you see, the crest is the highest point of the fold. This is the crest. If you see, this is the crest of the fold. However, if you see properly, the two limbs are meeting here, kind of. Here. The two limbs are meeting. Here the two limbs are meeting here, so this is the hinge line and this is the crest, highest part of the fold is the crest, is the hinge, see the points also, okay, the crest is the, at a higher elevation as compared to that of hinge, you're getting me, therefore top part of the fold is crest and hinge is where the two limbs meet, understand this, okay, fine, yeah, so we'll stop you for now and we'll continue you know with what are the different types of folds and nomenclature and all those things. Yes. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye.